Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. And in this video also, so guys, in this course, in this segment, Exchange Server 2019, this is my third video. In this video, we will understand how Exchange Server 2019 uses Active Directory or any Exchange Server. Okay, or you can say introduction to the integration of Active Directory and Exchange Server. I hope this video will be informative. And let me begin with this. So guys, to ensure the proper placement of Active Directory components in relation to computers running Exchange Server, you must understand how Exchange Server communicate with Active Directory and uses Active Directory information to function. Very important, because there are lots of components you need to deal with when you are dealing with Exchange Server. So you should have the proper information about it. The most Exchange Server configuration information is stored in Active Directory. That is why Active Directory is very important. So now guys, in my video I will be using 2 or 3 or 4 virtual machine in coming up videos for installation and configuration. So there will be one Active Directory, that is my domain india.com, and I will be using one secondary server. Okay, and I have installed server 2019 on both the server. I have both the server, you can see. If you want to see, let me verify you. This is my india.com domain, and this is my computer name and IP address I gave, and this is Windows Server 2019 standard evaluation version I have installed, and same on this server also. So as of now, this server is just plain server, just operating system only. No configuration, no installation. I will be deploying Windows Server Exchange Server on this server once my this video is over in my coming up videos. So let me begin with this, guys. Here, see, these are, once again, you need to understand. In my previous videos, 2 videos, I spoke a lot about what is forest, schema, configuration, domain and global catalog. These are the backbone, these are the backbone portion, or you can say configuration or component of this Exchange Server deployment. So once again, I will tell you what it is actually in short. Like forest, what will happen here? For example, this is your complete forest, okay, and this is called one tree. This is one tree, this is second tree. So they will keep exchanging information between all the trees in that forest, between all the DCs in that forest. That is known as one-to-one relationship. And if we talk about schema, so this will keep exchanging object classes and attributes. And if we talk about configuration, it keeps exchange of configuration and domain, exchange who is recipients. And if we talk about global catalog, so global catalog is like, you know, exchange object attributes for mail enabled and mail box enabled objects. Okay, 2 things here, and in more detail we will see here what is forest. So once again, I will have to tell the same thing. An Exchange Server organization and an Active Directory forest have one-to-one relationship. Okay, so there will be a one-to-one relationship between Exchange Server and Active Directory. You cannot have an Exchange Server organization that spans multiple Active Directory forest, and you also cannot have multiple Exchange Server organization within a single Active Directory forest. So for example, this is your forest, then you will have to use only one Exchange Server. Okay, and if you have one Exchange Server, then you cannot have multiple Active Directories. This is one thing need to take care about forest and how they are integrated. Next, schema partition. Schema partition is like, you know, the schema partition is modified during the Exchange Server installation to allow the creation of Exchange Server specific objects. When you install Exchange Server, there will be schema partition modification. Okay, and Exchange Server specific attributes are added during installation to existing objects. What does it mean? For example, I have one user here. Okay, I'm just telling you, just giving example. So let me go to users and computers. If I have created any user here, and the current attributes of this user this much, if anything is required while this integration of Active Directory, integration between Active Directory and Exchange Server, there will be certain changes for this user, okay, for this property of this user. So that is called schema change. Basically, and Exchange Server, just now I told you, Exchange Server specific attributes are added during installation to existing object. Next thing, for example, user objects are updated with additional attributes to describe storage quota and mailbox features. Okay, this kind of information will be updated to that existing object in the Active Directory, and that will be going to schema partition. Next one is configuration partition. What will happen in configuration partition now? The configuration partition stores configuration information for the Exchange Server organization, because Active Directory replicates the configuration partition among all the domain controllers in the forest. The configuration of the Exchange Server organization replicates throughout the forest, because if you have, for example, you have four server here, okay, you got four server and once again GC, and you have deployed any Exchange Server here on this one. So all other servers should know, all other DC should know, okay, this is Exchange Server. All objects should know, okay, this is Exchange Server, this server is responsible for mailing and all, okay, that should be done, and that will be replicating throughout the forest. The configuration partition includes Exchange Server configuration objects such as global setting, email address policy, and transport rules and address list. This kind of information will be included in configuration partition. Next, domain partition. If we talk about domain partition, so the domain partition holds information about the recipient objects, who is going to receive. Okay, receive. This includes like mailbox enabled users and mail enabled users, group and contacts. Next, objects that are mail enabled or mail enabled have attributes such as email address already configured. So this domain partition will be containing this kind of information. Now we talk about global catalog. So in this, when Exchange Server, if we talk about 7 or 8 or the upgraded version is installed, the email attributes for mail enabled and mailbox enabled objects are replicated to global catalog, and the global catalog then contain a list of Exchange Server, all the Exchange Server recipient that can be used to generate address list. Exchange Server also uses the global catalog when delivering message to find the location of the recipient mailbox. By default, global address list is generated from the list of the recipients in the Active Directory Forest global catalog. So this much information here, guys, in this video, what and all information will be coming to which portion of Active Directory partition basically, and what will be role. Please make a note of this much information given here, because it is not easy to remember each and everything. Just make a note whatever information you can capture from here. Okay, so guys, thanks for watching for this video, and you know what you have to do at the end of this video. And in next video, we'll be talking about Exchange Server roles and requirement for installation. Okay, what are the roles we had in previous flavor of Exchange Server, and what are the roles we have now in Server 2019. So I will be speaking about all those things. Okay, there are a couple of roles, there were lots of roles available in previous version of Exchange Server, and now they have made some certain changes in Exchange Server 13 or 10 or 16 or now in 19. So, but still I will speak about those previous roles also, okay, like this. And then we will be doing installation of Exchange Server 2019. So if you want to know about all those things, please subscribe the channel. and wait for my next video. Till then, bye bye.